Hello and Namaste. I am Jagat. I teach happiness. Are you looking for real and lasting happiness? According to Dr. Martin Seligman, the founder of positive psychology, authentic happiness comes from identifying and cultivating your main character strengths and using them every day in work, play, love, and parenting. In this video, I am going to tell you how to identify your signature strengths, cultivate them, and use them in the major arenas of life. Positive psychology has three pillars. First is the study of positive emotion like gratitude, joy, and optimism. Second is the study of positive traits, your signature strengths. Third is the study of positive institutions like democracy, free inquiry, free press, strong families. One of the most valuable work done in modern times by the positive psychologists has been the study of the core virtues. The psychologist studied about 200 sacred texts, right from Aristotle, Confucius, and Buddha, the Old Testament, the Upanishads, Quran, and all the philosophical schools, cultural customs, and they found that there are no more than six, no less than six core virtues which are included in each one of them. Let us see which these core virtues are. The first cluster of virtues is knowledge and wisdom. Every culture, every philosophy respects knowledge and wisdom. If you have to think of a person who personifies this virtue, you could think of Aristotle. And there are many routes to reach this virtue. One of the routes is curiosity or interest in the world. Or another route could be love of learning. Another route, social intelligence, personal intelligence. So to reach a virtue, there could be many routes. These are our signature strengths. The second virtue, which is widely respected across all religions and cultures, is courage. Not only physical courage, but also moral courage. Abraham Lincoln is a person because courage includes integrity and honesty also. Perseverance, integrity, valor, bravery, these are the roots to achieving this virtue. The third virtue is love and humanity. Who else could better represent this than Mother Teresa? Loving kindness, the capacity to love others and also be loved by others. So, kindness, generosity, and giving love, these are the roots to this virtue. Next virtue cluster has been named as justice. This is how you relate with larger groups, your family, community, your nation or country, and the whole world as such, to larger group of people. Citizenship, leadership, these are the roots to this virtue, and the whole world recognizes Mahatma Gandhi as an epitome of this virtue. The next virtue is temperance, modesty, humility, and I feel that this virtue is rare and difficult to cultivate. The best example in humanity across ages representing this virtue is none other than the Buddha. Moderate expression of your wants and needs, humility, patience, these are the roots by which you can reach this virtue. And the final cluster of virtues is transcendence and spirituality. Here you go beyond yourself to something larger, to excellence, looking for beauty, gratitude. And two very interesting roots here, because all the other signature strengths are slightly of a serious nature, like love of learning, courage, valor, integrity. There are two strengths which are slightly different, and they have been recognized across all cultures. One of them is playfulness and humor, and the other is zest and enthusiasm. It also includes spirituality, this cluster of values. So a person who could represent all these together, excellence in various fields, then spirituality, gratitude, playfulness. I thought Dalai Lama could be that person. So now let us see the six virtues: knowledge and wisdom, courage, love and humanity, justice, temperance, and transcendence and spirituality, and the various routes of reaching these virtues. There are six virtues and there are 24 routes by which you can reach these. Let us have a look at these virtues and the roots of reaching these virtues. Happiness is nothing but values in action, and even the classic philosophers have been telling us that the key aspect of living a happy life lies in the virtues. Let us have a look at the virtues and the roots to these virtues.
To achieve the virtue of knowledge and wisdom, the roots are curiosity or interest in the world, love of learning, judgment or critical thinking, that is open-mindedness, ingenuity, originality, creativity, practical intelligence, social, personal and emotional intelligence, and perspective. The next virtue, courage, can be achieved through valor and bravery, perseverance, industry or diligence, and integrity, genuineness or honesty. Humanity and love is the next cluster of virtues, and it may be reached through kindness and generosity. Loving others and allowing yourself to be loved by others. Justice can be achieved through citizenship, duty, teamwork, loyalty. Through fairness and equity, and also through leadership. The virtue of temperance may be attained by self-control, prudence, discretion or caution, and humility and modesty. To achieve transcendence and spirituality, the roots are appreciation of beauty and excellence, gratitude, hope, optimism, future-mindedness, spirituality or sense of purpose, faith, religiousness, playfulness and humor, zest, passion and enthusiasm. To know your highest strengths, go to the website www.authentichappiness.org and take the VIA survey of character strengths test. This 25-minute exercise rank orders your strengths from top to bottom and compares your answers to thousands of other people. Immediately after taking it, you'll get detailed feedback about your strengths.
So after taking the test VIA survey of character strengths, have a good look at your five top signature strengths. Do they look like you? When was the last time you used one of your signature strengths and felt really good? If you want to be happy in life, you have to use these character strengths every day or as often as you can in work, play, love and parenting, that is at home and at work, everywhere, and you'll feel good. For example, love of learning is one of my core strengths. So I keep on learning new things every day, and I share whatever new I learn with my friends and family. That is why I am making this video for you. Next time I learn something more and share that also with you. Another core strength that I have is playfulness. So I have learned and developed the skills of laughter yoga. I laugh with people, students, teachers, factory workers, office goers, seniors, and when I laugh with them, play with them, sing and dance with them, I feel good. So I try to find ways and means to reach people and engage with them, laugh with them, play with them. So if you want to be happy in life, you should first of all know your top core strengths, signature strengths, and whatever you feel good, whichever strengths you feel good to use them, find ways and means and use them as often as you can. You'll be happy, you'll be flourishing, and you'll also make those around you flourish. So be happy and stay blessed.